Hello everybody, welcome back to e-learning at Virtuous CC. Today, we're very excited because we're going to learn something very cool, very new, and very cultured. My name is Elson, 我是永辉，今天非常高兴，因为我们会学一个很好的东西，我们学品茶的文化。那在我身旁的老师Roy, Roy 你好,
你好，跟大家说你好,
可以吗？Hi,
大家好。
Hey, 那今天要跟我们分享的是什么东西呢？
我今天分享的是一些茶的文化，茶的历史。 就是茶有 tea classifications, six different classifications, then 一点点关于茶跟 art and science of tea, 关于一点科学的，关于一点点文化的，关于茶这方面，最后还show给你们看怎么去泡一汤普洱茶。
Alright, so today we're going to learn about the Chinese tea culture. We learn a little bit about history. We learn about tea classification, and the most important is health benefit. At this time now, we're all thinking about how to live a healthier lifestyle, how to build our immunity and everything. And we know in the Chinese tradition, medicine and tea culture, that tea has a lot of health benefit. And today, our expert, our teacher, Roy, is going to bring us through that whole process. So you're in for a great time. So let's talk a little bit about history, okay? I enjoy coffee, tea, but I don't call myself a tea connoisseur, Roy. You have a lot of experience and you graduated in China studying tea, right?
Yes.
So I'm sure you have a lot more that you can share with us. So talking about tea history, I know about ancient China, the dynasties, and the king always liked to drink tea.
Yes.
皇上很喜欢品茶，不好的茶他不喜欢，要上等的茶。那我们今天学习的茶，的历史方面呢，你可以跟我们分享茶是从哪里开始的？
Tea basically all the tea, 全世界的茶, all start from China, 从中国开始的。 Then after that, during the Song Dynasty, as the saying goes, 开门七件事，茶颜油米酱醋茶。 That means that during the Song Dynasty, everybody start the life in the Chinese typical Chinese family. They require three necessities, meaning they require firewood. They require oil, they require rice, they require salt, they require sauce, they require vinegar, and lastly, they require tea.
So tea is a necessity, seven necessities.
Yes.
Yep, okay. And that's from the Song Dynasty. So yes, now tea has traveled through, all right, with human all the way to today, 2020.
茶扮演着很多很重要关于健康的角色, that's number one. So during the past, people also recognize that tea does bring a lot of health benefits until to this present day.
Yep.
So we drink tea not only for the health benefits, also we drink tea for the palate, for the enjoyment at the same time. So tea classifications can classify into under TCM concept, basically we're looking at tea in terms of cooling, in terms of neutral, and in terms of warm.
Yep.
So tea that are fully fermented tends to be on the warm side.
Okay.
Half fermented is considered more or less neutral.
Okay.
And tea that never go through any fermentation like green tea tends to be on the very cooling side.
So 绿茶是凉的?
凉性的,对。
那很像其他的茶,像他们说 Ang Mo Tea 咧, Black Tea, Earl Grey Tea, English Breakfast Tea. What do we classify?
English Breakfast Tea, English they call it Black Tea. But in terms of Chinese classification, it's classified as Red Tea. 是属于红茶,
okay.
红茶是属于比较温性的。温性, that means considered warm.
Okay.
So the art of tea, drinking tea, is that not all tea suited for everybody's body type. Because if your body type is on the cooling side, you drink a lot of green tea, you tend to have bloated stomach, you tend to have sleepless night, you tend to have leg cramps during the night.
That's because you got to, because caffeine is higher.
No, because it's very cooling. If your body type is cooling, you drink something cooling, you will not feel comfortable. You're topping the scale. So TCM talking about balance.
Balance
is the key.
阴阳是吗?
Yeah, 调和.
The balance.
Yeah, balance. Yeah.
Harmony.
Harmony, correct.
Yes, yes.
Okay, you live so best when you're in balance.
Exactly. So then if I have body ache, you know, it means that it's cooling, is it?
No, you have your body ache depends. It can come from different sectors. But so assuming that if you're not sleeping, you're burning through, working through the night, and you got sore throat, then you drink green tea is really good for you. Because at that time, you got sore throat, it tends to be more
heated,
like 发热, 上火了, 我们叫上火, 所以你喝绿茶会对你很好。
所以每次妈妈每次说, you know, mommy said, okay, you not enough sleep, 喝凉茶, 凉茶都是凉性的,
correct.
Then that's why it brings down the flame in my body,
right?
Then I feel better after that, because it is helping me to balance.
Yes, you feel healthier also.
Oh, so knowing my body type is also very important, 知道我自己身体的那个
状况。对。
所以有时我是带凉，有时我是温，有时我是中。
也是。
所以我也是要知道了。But naturally, our body types will lean to one certain.
Correct.
Yeah. So you say young people can drink more 凉。
Yeah, more green tea,
white green tea. So green tea people say weight loss, is it true?
Yeah, correct. Because of the antioxidants it packs in it, it also helps you with the weight loss, cholesterol, lower down your cholesterol, your bad cholesterol, help you lower down your bad cholesterol, prevent heart disease, stuff like that. It's all has been scientifically proven. You can just Google from that.
So a lot of health benefit. So for young people, drink green tea, a lot of health benefit. Does it apply the same to older people?
Not really, because older people, we tend to be on the cooling aspect slowly. Our circulation is much slower as we age. Okay. So if you drink a lot of green tea, you have trouble walking. You got very weak legs.
Okay, 所以是这么说的，年轻的时候呢，我们喝绿茶是对身体非常好的，有很多好处，对吗？
对。
瘦身啊，降我的血压啊，它还有什么其他的帮助呢？
就是避免一些疾病，就是说心脏病这类东西都能避免的。
可是因为有这么多好事，如果我想把绿茶给奶奶爷爷喝，不一定是好的。
对，
因为我们在年老慢慢年长的时候呢，我们身体的那个状况会改变。
对，
那老的时候呢，可能我们的血液循环会开始慢下来。
对，
那身体就会越来越凉，带凉，对吗？
对，所以我们偏凉。
偏凉，
对
，right must follow the right term。偏凉，那我们喝绿茶的时候，身体就会有酸痛，
对。
那晚上就不能睡觉，
对。
All right, so it's very important. So if you're older, so don't anyhow feed green tea to you know nenek, you know your grandfather, anything, because you must know that our body condition change.
Correct.
And when you change, and when they drink green tea, the problem will come. Green tea is very high in caffeine. They cannot sleep. Double tido, 不可以睡觉。Problem come, you know, body ache. So for older people, what kind of tea would you recommend better health benefit?
Black tea is the best.
Why?
Black tea, because firstly, it's fully fermented. And black tea got different categories. I strongly recommend you can try Fu Zhuan.
Fu Zhuan?
This is the only black tea that comes with golden fungus in it. Not only is good in terms of basically lower your bad cholesterol, at the same time, it packs with a lot of these, we call it probiotics.
Okay, 抗生素。
抗生素。Yep, it's like taking your yogurt is about the same, but this is 100% natural, developed within the tea. So it helps as you age, your digestive system don't tend to work as well as when you are young. So this helps you to break down the food better and absorb better absorption.
Wow, okay, that's very good. So older people, black tea. Alright, 福砖是最好
的。福砖 is one of the best.
福砖 is one of the best, right? So remember that, I think we have already gained so much value from that, and we want to dive into the tea culture.
Okay.
We want teacher to bring us through that culture, right?
Okay.
To teach us, and today, what is the tea that we're going to use?
The tea we'll be using today is called the 2019, considered a green tea right now. This pool is coming from a 100 to 150 years old tea tree. We call this 古树普洱茶,古树.
Oh, so 那个树The tree is 150 years old,
correct.
But the leaf is young.
Yeah, no, coming from this, the leaf it come from this 150 years old tea tree. So because when the tree is about 100 years old, then we can classify this as 古树.
Okay.
Yeah, we can consider, we call this ancient tea cake.
Okay.
Because it's above 100 years
old. Can we have a look at the tea cake?
Definitely.
Please?
Can open up, can take a look at the tea cake. So as you can see from the date here, it's 2019.
Okay, so it's 2019, so we can see it's like wine.
Correct. So that's how the tea cake looks like.
So and then we talk about the aging process. So and it's in relation to being cooling or warm.
So now, right now, it's more on the cooling aspect.
Mm.
So if you keep this for 5 years, 6 years after fermentation, because this tea don't stay the same. Naturally, you'll be naturally fermenting. So you can notice there's flavor coming up, meaning that it's fermenting.
Alright.
So after 5 years, this tea will be not considered cooling anymore.
Okay.
It's considered more of neutral.
Okay.
If you keep for another 10 years, it's considered more towards the warm side, warm aspect.
Okay. So it looks like there are so many things that we're going to learn later, right? Mm-hmm. So before we start and dive right into the lesson, let's see what we need to begin tea appreciation.
Okay, I'll just give a brief introduction. Firstly, you will need a teapot, which is either be a metal teapot or a silver teapot is equally good. At least this will bring the temperature up to 100 degrees.
Okay.
Then the 紫砂pot go best with 普洱茶. This is a sharing cup, then plus the teacup, of course. Then this is basically for you dispense your water. Then plus some teacups. And another one is that you require would be the filter for the tea. Then this usually is we call the tea cap resting
Wow.
So you can just place your tea cap over this.
Okay.
So this is the whole set. It comes usually in the market as a set. This one is for you to take the tea, and this for you if the teapot is stuck, this little thing helps you to basically unblock it. Mm-hmm. And this is for you to pick up. If there's a big chunk of tea, you can use instead of your hand, you can use this to pick it up. It's more hygienic. Mm. And lastly, this widens the teapot. So at least there will not be any tea when you dispense the tea inside, it will not be tea all over the place.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we have all these, we're ready to start. Yeah. And tea is not an individual activity. You can actually share it with people, and that's why we have sharing cups. So, you know, we learn this. 学好了,那在家里的时候, when you're at home, 你可以跟家人一起分享这个茶的文化, the tea culture. At the same time, tea is a good time to catch up with one another.
Definitely.
Am I right?
Yes.
Because you take time to brew, and I'm sure we will learn so much later. We're all excited. I'm sure you are. And if we are ready, Roy, would you be able to take us through that process of learning and appreciating tea?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Most
Let's
welcome.
Start.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Thanks for logging in. My name is Roy. Today, I'll be basically doing a very brief introduction on Chinese tea in terms of the history, the classification of tea, the art and science of tea, and lastly, the brewing of pu'er tea. History-wise, tea has been in the Chinese family as early, according to records, as early as the Song Dynasty, that is dated about close to 1,000 over years back. As a Chinese saying, 茶言有米,酱醋茶. This is a slogan that to start the day, since as early as the Song Dynasty, we require firewood, rice, oil, salt, sauce, vinegar, and tea. From this slogan, you can see that the history for tea dated back 1,000 over years back. It can be even longer. And the classification of tea basically is divided into six major categories. The first category is green tea. Green tea is the only tea categories that never go through any fermentation. Then followed by white tea, yellow tea, half-fermented tea, we classify that. And after that, red tea, and lastly, black tea. So, as everybody is aware, there's a lot of research has been done on tea. Tea holds a big benefits in terms of if you consume it on a regular basis. Like they're packed with a lot of antioxidants like polyphenols, in the sense that these antioxidants basically helps to prevent our body and cells against free radicals. This is one. Secondly, flavonoids and other antioxidants basically helps to prevents our body through long consumptions against cancer and stroke, heart disease, stuff like that. On the pu'er tea itself, pu'er tea is the only tea that basically, when upon harvest, is considered a green tea. Upon long, if you were to keep it for the next 10 to 20 years, over the time, it will slowly ferment into a full fermented tea, considered, we call it ripe pu'er tea in that sense. Another type for pu'er tea to also go through another age of classification is through human fermentation. This pu'er tea, within a period of about 1 to 2 months, it becomes a ripe pu'er. So pu'er tea is very unique in its own classification itself, is that it can be a raw tea, can be like as good as a green tea to start off upon harvest, or it can be a cooked tea, fully fermented tea, if you go through a long man-induced fermentation. So pu'er tea got two different classifications. So coming back to the body and art and taste of doing tea is that, in terms of the art-wise, is that for tea itself, there's a long classification in terms of how you brew the tea, the equipment you use, the water also play a very important role in brewing tea, plus the quality of the tea. Tea coming from a 2-year-old tea plant, and versus tea coming from a 100-year-old tea plant, the taste is different. In terms of the terrain the tea plant is being grown, it's also going to taste different. Therefore, to choose the right tea, there's a lot of details and knowledge that everyone got to take your time to go dive deep into it to fully understand the nature of this particular tea. Then, in terms of the science of it, TCM classified every food in terms of cooling, neutral, and warm. So if your body structure is more on the cooling aspect, if you consume a lot of green tea, the telltale signs what your body will react to, you tend to have basically very weak legs, or you tend to have get a lot of cramps on your legs. You tend to have bloated stomach. Plus, green tea usually consists of higher caffeine content. You tend to have a lot of sleepless nights. So therefore, consuming tea that suitable to your body, this is the best way I encourage everybody to go forward to. Then white tea, these are the tea that have the least fermentation. They tend to be more on the cooling aspect. White tea, yellow tea, these are the tea that is very cooling. And half fermented tea are more towards the neutral, whereas the fully fermented tea, Chinese have got a saying, say lao ren cha, meaning that old man tea. Those who are fully fermented tea, they tend to be on the warm aspect. So for people who are more elderly, they drink the tea that is fully fermented, they don't tend to have weak knees or weak legs. They tend to feel more energized to a certain extent. And tea overall does help to basically lower one's cholesterol, weight issues, and heart disease. All this prevention all goes into hand in hand. So today I'll be basically showcasing to you this particular tea that being harvested in Sichuan Pana in the year 2019. Why 2019? 2019 is the year considered over the last 5 years is the driest climate at that time. Why? The tea, when you harvest this particular tea, because of the dry climate, when you fry the tea sap tends to be very, very powerful, very sticky and strong. So if the tea leaf itself is very, very powerful, you can assure that if you keep this tea for the next 20 years, it's like a good bottle of wine. Those that harvest from the first growth will tend to have a lot of potential to keep it for a long period. Those tea that is basically coming from a 2 years old plant, if you keep it for the next 10, 20 years, this tea will be literally tasteless. However, this tea packed with a lot of nutrients, after 20 years, it will develop into a very, very robust taste in terms of very deep, in terms of leathery nose, a leathery palate, in terms of nose-wise, will be very strong dark fruits nose that comes with it. So I'll be opening up this tea to show it to you how is it being done on the brewing side. So you're going to take a closer look. As you can see, tea coming from an old tea plant, you can see that all these are hand-packed, so that's why it's not through machine. It's quite not too tightly packed. If it's over-tightly packed, the fermentation period will not be as uniform, as good as compared to a machine pack. That's how you open up a tea from inside out. So opening up this tea, the reason of piercing this metal needle inside out is that to prevent that if you were to put your hand in front, it might pierce into you. So doing this way is a safer way of opening up the tea. Usually we will do about 20 to 30% of the tea on the teapot. Okay, before we scrub the tea, we tend to take the opener to put it on the teapot so that I will not spill out the tea when I put it on. So this is the tea that I will put it on. That's how it looks like. You can see from the camera. This tea aside. This is a tea strainer. Then we will heat up the water. So water coming from silver pot as versus water coming from electric kettle, this will yield 100% degrees water. So for pour a tea like this, we require temperature at growing at about 100 degrees, not anything lower, 80 degrees. Especially for old tea, temperature is even a more critical role. If you do old tea at 80 degrees, you will not be able to extract the flavor of the tea out from the tea itself. So when the water is boiling, this we sort of wake up the tea. We do the tea in slow motion. So the first extraction, we tend to rinse the tea at the same time we wake up the flavor of the tea. Then we use this first extraction to warm up the teacups. As you can see, even on the first brew itself, the nose starts to show itself on the first brew. So we just dispense the first brew, so that the teacup is stay warm. Then, now we're going for the actual brew now. This is considered the first brew. Tea coming from these old tea plants can go as many as close to 20 to 25 brew easily. So, first few brew, usually the timing for the brewing will be take less than about 5 seconds. You can just dispense out the tea soup anytime. So you can see the color comes out straight away. And try the tea here. Then you can nose the flavor of the tea from this sharing pot. Since this tea is new, it tends to have a very nice floral nose at this point in time, but over time it will slowly develop into a more matured nose. So on the palate itself, very smooth, despite it's very new. At the same time, very floral on the nose, light for the time being. After the third brew, usually the tannin will start to surface itself. Let me proceed to the second brew. So on the second brew itself, the brewing timing will be almost about the same. We won't put it more than 5 seconds to 6 seconds brew. We have to fully dispense out all the tea soup from the teapot so that you will not basically over extract the tea and get very, very tannic on the palate. As you can see from the second brew itself, the tea soup colors turns even darker on the second brew. So to fast forward a little bit, I will dispense this first tea soup. I'll go to the second one. On the second brew, as you can see, the tea soup is stronger. I expect a much robust taste on the palate. The sweetness starts to surface on the palate. The fragrance still stays. The floral fragrance still stays very well. But usually on the third or the fourth brew onwards, you can see that the tannin will start to surface on itself. The tannin are basically the antioxidants which I mentioned earlier. Antioxidants are the one that is basically aids in our health, well-being, our body well-being, and basically help us to get rid of all the free radicals from our system. Okay, we will dispense this for the second brew. We'll move on to the third brew. Usually for pu'er tea, the third brew usually will truly show up the full character of the tea itself in terms of the flavor, the nose, and the entire palate. Now the thing is brewing. From here, when we come to tea tasting, especially going to a tea exhibition, we tend to wait for the brewer to do the third brew, then we start to do the tasting because there's so many vendors around, especially in the exhibition. So usually third brew is the brew to determine whether how good the tea is. Now I'm dispensing out the third brew. As you can see, the color of the tea soup itself still stay bright and vibrant. In fact, the color gets a little bit deeper. So let me try out the first brew, the third brew. This tea is perfect. Let's invite Alson in to try this third brew, see how it tastes like.
Wow, Roy, yes. This is really good, yeah?
You can try this.
So, how do I hold the cup?
You know? Usually, we hold the cups in one hand like this. Three, two. Two below, one at the side.
Difficult to balance.
Yeah, you balance it this way and you drink.
With that sound?
You sip a little bit air in at the same time. You get the nose, the tea. You get the full palate of the tea on on your palate. At least you can nose it at the same time, you can taste it.
So I must smell also?
Yeah, when you nose it, you can if you really want to smell the tea itself, you can do it on this sharing cup. Because the surface is bigger, so when you nose it, you get the full flavor of it. You can try this.
Okay.
You can take this and you can just know this.
So you can use this to
taste it, right? Yeah, you taste it, you taste it, the taste. What taste?
普洱了，带有很多花香味。现在它对普洱是什么花做的？不是普洱是一棵茶树，这个是属于古茶树，属于那为什么会有花香呢？花香
because the when the, this is 2019年 的普洱is a new it's almost like green tea. Green tea when you drink green tea is very fragrant on the nose because why the tea leaf is very new. It haven't go through the long fermentation process.
Okay,
once it start to ferment, the deeper flavors and notes will start to kick in. Okay. Same thing as wine. A new wine, you find that it's very fragrant on the nose.
Yep.
But if you keep the wine for 20 years, you see that leather nose, tobacco nose, all start the deeper notes will all start to set in.
So that's why this is very light.
This very light.
Floral.
Yeah, floral. And this is also packed with very high in antioxidants at this point.
Antioxidants is very good for health. 非常健康。
对。
那这个就是很像可以给身体非常的健康。那这个茶叶是2019年，
对，
所以你说比较新的茶叶，
对，
它的味道就比较
花香味会比较浓，
花香不是淡哈，
不
是
花
香
味
比
较浓花香味比较浓。
那比较久的茶，收了比较久的茶，那个味道就会
它的味道就比较沉的味道，
很沉，
就是收了很久的话，你有一股泥土的味道，也有皮革的味道就上来了。
哇 okay,
就是这些是收了很久的茶味。
Okay.
可是有一点霉的味道就不好了，就不好喝了。
Alright, so when it's like sour,
then when it's like moldy, so if you keep this tea in a very wet environment, it tends to be very moldy. So that in fact is very bad.That will cause cancer if you drink that a lot.
Oh wow, okay, so that's very important.
Yes.
So we don't think that we keep the tea for a long time, then when someone drinks it, why a bit moldy? Oh, it's good because long time, no, right?
No, it's not.
So if it's leathery, heavy note,
correct.
It's good. Yeah. But if it's moldy, spoil.
Cannot drink.
Do not drink, okay?
Yes,
这是一个非常重要的东西。如果已经开始有霉味发霉了，就不要喝。可以看一下吗？我们怎么样收呢？如果我要所以这个是2019年的茶对吗？
对，2019年 ，you can see the date from here 2019.
Okay,
this date itself 2019.
那我收怎么样收藏那个茶叶呢？
收这个茶叶，第一点空气要不会有异味。That means they shouldn't have any other flavors that goes within the environment when they keep the tea.
Okay, so you want to keep it in a space where there's no mixture of strong smell.
Yeah. No perfume, no detergent.No anything that got flavors to it.
Okay.
Should be in a clean environment. That's number one.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, in Singapore itself, you're keeping a pool of tea is 10 times better than you keep it in a climate that got 4 seasons. Reason being, because our climate is firstly humid and its temperature is warm. So it aids the fermentation so much faster.
Okay.
However, the setback is, in this environment, you don't control the moisture, more will surface very fast.
Okay.
So there's a saying that if you keep one pool tea in Singapore in 1 year, it's versus like 3 to 5 years if you keep it in China in a cool environment, like in Beijing, stuff like that. I got some tea that...
所以新加坡因为我们闷热，
对，
所以它发酵的比较快，
对，
所以我们就可以品尝那个深度，
对，
那个茶的那个深度会比较快，
对。
Alright, 这个是非常非常好的东西，对吗？所以我会品尝茶，可能在比较冷的国家 ，cold places.
Yes,
I have to wait very long. But in Singapore, I can buy a freshly prepared tea leaf.
Yeah,
I enjoy the floral taste.
Yes,
and then I keep it in 1 year's time. I can enjoy the new note.
Correct.
So I just need to make sure that I don't place into some place that's over humid.
Correct.
When mold start to grow,
then
it becomes moldy, it's spoiled.
Correct.
It causes cancer.
Yes.
Yeah? If I place in a place in a cupboard, I put everything inside together, biscuit lah, then got strong smell, durian,
perfume
everything.
Perfume lah, all
this. Then there's a problem. It's no good as well.
Correct.
So I don't Do I put it in a container? Does it need to be airtight?
If you don't have this condition to keep in the room by itself for tea, then if you need to keep with other product, yes, then you best you airtight it. So other flavors don't intrude into the tea.
Ziploc
bag is also equally good. Yeah, you can keep it airtight.
Okay,
you
don't have
that. 条件没有那么好的话，那你就最好跟它密封。 条件好的话，那你就一个房间单单长茶是最好的。当你长单单长茶的话，因为我们这里的环境是特别湿，所以一定要放一架除湿机在里面 ，dehumidifier。
dehumidifier.
Yeah, you need to put a dehumidifier if you strictly want to keep tea. Okay. I do know a tea merchant in basically Malaysia. He bought in tea by the tons, by the container.
Uh-huh.
Then he keep it for 5-6 years. He sell it back to China because the tea developed until very nice.
Wow.
Very nice notes. So he sell it double the price when he send it back
so
to China.
So our climate here is very good to enjoy tea actually.
Yes,
and
is.
The tea culture is beautiful.
Exactly.
You know, 品茶的那个文化 非常多东西能够学习。那品茶的时候，我们学习这个茶艺，对吗？茶艺的时候呢，我们耐心，可以练我们的耐心，是吗？
对。
So when we practice tea, brewing tea is very good, you know, because you stay calm, you learn to be patient, and you learn to enjoy the moment.
Yes.
At this time now, 我们大家都在家, we're all at home.
Yeah.
Yeah, got nothing to do.
Yes.
Right? We want to lim kopi.
Yeah.
We want to drink tea. Might as well do something like that. You know, you can talk to your family members, brew, enjoy the first brew can drink, not? Huh?
First brew, usually we wake up the tea.
Wake up the tea, all right.
Yeah,
then second brew.
Yeah. The first, the one wake up the tea, we don't consider the first brew. We just say we wake up the tea, or we rinse the tea. Then after that, the first brew, we really drink the first brew.
Okay.
Second brew, third brew is the best brew. Usually the third brew shows the character of the tea.
Exactly. So like what 我们的老师说的, you know, you can take the time, 品尝 the layers, slowly the different flavors, and the third brew will be perfect. By then, you know, you'll be happy and you'll be talking and getting in a conversation and everything.
Yes.
So we talk about pu'er tea today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what other tea would you recommend for us to enjoy as well, based on whatever that we've learned today?
Okay, in terms of pu'er tea, this is a very unique tea. Why I surfaced this today was because now it's considered like a green tea. If I keep it for the next 10 years, it's considered a medium sort of mid half fermented tea.
Yep.
Then if you keep for another 20 years, it's considered fully fermented tea. So for this one particular tea cakes, you get a whole spectrum of from light all the way to the heaviest, both sides of the scale.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. So that's why it's a very good tea to start learning
tea
ceremony and to enjoy tea.
Exactly.
谢谢老师. Yeah, 那我们学习学了很多东西. We learned so much, you know, about tea, appreciating tea.
Yes.
Tea is very connected to the Chinese culture.
Yes.
You know, pu'er tea comes from a place in China, and you have talked about the aging process and how it actually evolves, you know.
Yes.
And I think if we purchase the tea and we really learn and go through that process, we actually grow and we actually become better in tea appreciation together with our tea cake.
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, I think this is a very fantastic time to appreciate and to learn different cultures.
Yes.
You know, for Chinese, sometimes we want to learn the roots of our own culture. So, 谢谢老师, once again, thank you, Roy, for teaching us. I hope that you have learned something today. You know, e-learning and virtual CCs want to bring you a lot of exciting and very nice knowledge, all right, that you can practice, you can learn at home, you know, and you can share with your family while we are all at home. So, thank you so much, Roy, once again. 谢谢大家.
谢谢.
Thank you for joining us. E-learning at Virtual CC. We have many more programs lined up for you, and we are very excited to see you. So I'll see you soon at the next episode of E-learning at Virtual CC. Bye bye.
Bye. Thank you.